Hi guys, this is John from Meat Justics University, and this is Wild Game Goose Pepperoni. We recently came into a lot of goose meat, and I mean a lot. So we decided to make some snack sticks with it. Gonna do a couple things differently than on a normal snack stick. First thing we're gonna do is after you've cleaned it, we're gonna soak it for 24 hours in salt water. This is gonna bleed the goose breast almost completely. Try to make it without doing that, and you're gonna run into taste and consistency problems. So go ahead and soak it for 24 hours in a cooler in salt water and let it bleed. We're also, instead of using a true snack stick seasoning, we're gonna make pepperoni sticks. So really the only difference there is that we're gonna use that seasoning and we're gonna try a couple of different casings. We're gonna try the regular 19 millimeter smoked collagen casing, but we're also gonna try the 26 millimeter cellulose casing. This is a casing that's not edible, so it's gonna end up with a skinless product. Use these more and more in the past, finding that we really like them. And we think with something like a pepperoni for goose, it's gonna come out awesome. So we've got 10 pounds of goose breast that we're using here, and we were lucky enough to get actual straight pork fat from our butcher. Now, normally you have to call ahead and order that, but they just happen to have some in stock. So what we're doing is we're taking 2 pounds of pork fat, and we're gonna mix that in when we're grinding the goose. So for grinding the goose, we're gonna do 2 grinds. First one's gonna be through a 3/8 plate just to break it all up. And as you can see, this is basically frozen hard. What we do is pack our goose meat into a long, thin 8-inch roll, and then we vacuum seal that up into 10-pound packages. So when we're ready to process, we just go ahead and start. So instead of waiting for this to totally defrost, I just went ahead and cut it up into chunks that were small enough to fit down my grinder's throat and started going at it. It made grinding a lot easier and quicker, especially on that second grind. Now, speaking of the second grind, this is where we're gonna add in our pork fat. I'm gonna try and just mix it in here so that it's evenly distributed throughout all of the goose. It's obviously not gonna be perfect, but we'll take care of that in the next phase, which is the mixing. Now, a couple things, since this was frozen, it was a lot easier to deal with, but if you don't have frozen goose breast, just make sure it's very cold and put your grinder head assembly, including your plates and knives, in the freezer first. It's really important with wild game that we keep the temperatures very far down. As far as mixing goes, we're gonna go ahead and we're using the pepperoni seasoning. We're using some cure that I mixed in with the water. Then we're adding some sodium erythorbate instead of encapsulated citric acid, since some of the people I'm making this with don't really like the tang from citric acid. We're using sodium erythorbate. Sodium erythorbate's a good cure accelerator as long as you have a scale that's accurate enough to measure very small amounts. 7/8 of an ounce of sodium erythorbate works for 100 pounds of meat as a cure accelerator. So for a 10-pound batch, we need a very small amount. So just make sure if you're gonna try this that you have a really accurate gram scale. Anytime you're making snack sticks or a cured product out of wild game, I highly recommend you use sure gel. Normally I'd use something like carrot fiber, but with wild game, we really wanna make sure we get it right, and sure gel does the best job of binding everything together. In the past when we've made goose sticks, we've done a 50-50 mix of this and pork butts. So we're using actual pork fat this time, and that sure gel is gonna do a good job of keeping everything bound together for us. Now we're gonna mix this, being careful to change directions about every minute until we're almost at the level of protein extraction we want. Right before that, we're gonna mix in our cheese and then start mixing that. Now the cheese probably would be fine if we added it right from the beginning, but there is the chance that it'll smear a little bit, and we just wanna make it as perfect as possible. So we're adding it during the last minute. Now you can tell you have good protein extraction when you start pulling it apart and it stretches instead of just breaking, or if you hold it upside down in your hand, it won't fall right out. Another good way to tell is if you take the entire mixer and hold it over a pan and try to just shake it out and it doesn't want to come, that means you've got some good protein extraction. An important thing to note here is how dark this meat is. Goose meat is really unlike pork or even beef in how dark it is. I mean, it looks almost like blood red. You'll notice this when you're grinding it, definitely when you're mixing it, But when you go to stuff it, that cure is starting to interact with the meat, and especially since we used a cure accelerator, and it turns it, instead of a gray color, a brown color. It's really weird to look at, but that is what you're looking for. Nothing's wrong with your meat if you have a dark brown color. So we're ready to stuff. First thing we're gonna stuff is our 17 millimeter smoked collagen casings. Now what we're doing is grabbing the largest stuffing tube that this will fit over. We've already packed our canister, making sure that we don't have any air pockets in there, and we're just gonna stuff until the casing is almost full and smooth. What you're really looking for here is there is a swirl pattern that will go down the casing. If you can just faintly see that, that's when you know you've got it correctly stuffed. If you see that just too easily, you're understuffing, and if you don't see it at all, you're overstuffing, and your casing's probably gonna break when you go to hang it in your smoker. The other casing we're using is this 26 millimeter cellulose casing, which, like I said before, is an inedible casing. That means that it's going to have to be peeled off before we go and eat it. It is easy to peel off. Sometimes you can just push it out one end, and if not, it does have a nice black line down the middle of it to let you know that the casing is still there. For these, we're gonna go ahead and stuff it till it's full and smooth. You really shouldn't have to worry about blowouts with these. It's a strong casing. Now for the snack sticks we made out of the smoked collagen, we're just gonna hang those over a smoke stick and cut them until they're in the right lengths for our smoker. For the cellulose casing, we're gonna try a couple of different things. On some of them, I'm gonna do the butcher's link where I get three links of equal size in a rope. It's a pretty easy thing to do. We have other videos on it. It can be hard to get going on this, but once you've learned how to do it, it is super simple and you'll remember it for life. It's a lot easier than manually tying in between each link on these cellulose casings. Another option is the Walton's manual sausage linker. This works on a string process, and you simply load your sausage in this end, bring it as far as out as you want, and turn this handle on the back rapidly 4 or 5 times in a clockwise direction, then quickly at the end of that 1 or 2 times in a counterclockwise direction, just to loosen some of that string. Now if you're getting it right and you do it fast enough, you should have a really well closed sausage. You'll have really nice marks on the end of it, similar to what you'd see in most commercial hot dogs. So we're done, we just took these out of the smokehouse, and the first thing I want everyone to look at is the beautiful color on these. I mean, that goose is a nice dark red, both inside and the outside of the casing is gorgeous too. You can see on the cellulose casings that it's got a nice shininess to it, whether or not it's got the casing on. Once we peeled the first casing off, I was not sure we actually got it all off till we took a bite into it. I mean, they are beautiful and shiny. It's important to note here that the texture on these is totally different than it would be if we just used pork, or even if we had used a 50-50 mix of pork and goose. You've got a really nice light airiness from the goose, but since we were able to get just pork fat, you still have the really nice creaminess of that pork fat. So if you can, it's worth a little extra effort to get that pork fat instead of going with a 50-50 mix. It made for a much different and, in my opinion, better snack stick. I think I might like these even better than I like the straight pork ones. I mean, this is excellent. Pepperoni and goose work incredibly well together. Now to smoke these, we went ahead and started our smoker at 120 degrees with all the vents wide open, let it run for 30 minutes, and this was our drying phase. We then went ahead and closed the dampers down most of the ways, added smoke, and cooked it for an hour at 130 degrees. We then upped that to 140 degrees for 30 minutes. Then we went ahead to 160 degrees for another hour, and then we went to 180 degrees until the internal temperature was 160 degrees. Now, we were able to run a shower cycle on this, but if your home smoker doesn't have a shower cycle, like 99% of them won't, go ahead and throw them in an ice bath. So just fill a lug up with ice water and toss them in there for about 10 minutes. We're doing this to stop the cooking process and to help set the casing to the meat. Also on the cellulose casings, that's how you're gonna get it out. So with the collagen casings, it sets it to the meat, and with cellulose casing, it allows the meat to release from the casing. Otherwise, you're gonna leave a lot of meat on the casing when you're peeling it off. So all in all, these are incredible. If you have goose, I highly recommend you make pepperoni sticks out of them. They're delicious. Couple quick things to remember. 24-hour soak in salt water before you start processing. Freeze it nice and solid before you go to grind, and then just cut that frozen meat up into chunks your grinder can handle. Use pepperoni, and if you want even more of that tang, add encapsulated citric acid. You might want to freeze your cheese too before you put it in. We did that with this, and you've got beautifully defined cheese throughout. Now these cellulose casings, I'm liking them more and more. For a pepperoni, that's a really cool size, or for a pepperoni stick, that's a really cool size. And they're really easy to work with, especially if you can either do that butcher's link or you have the Walton's automatic sausage linker. As always, remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and visit waltonsinc.com and meatgistics.com to find everything about the meat. Thanks for watching. I'm John with Meatgistics University, and we'll see you guys next time.
Subscribe to Walton's YouTube channel to watch more amazing videos, or shop at waltonsinc.com to find everything but the meat. Watch our latest sales and giveaway video by clicking here, or watch another hand-picked video by clicking here.